Oh, I think I saw Cat and David drive up. Wait, hide everything.
Hey, hurry. I'll put this in the kitchen.
Come on.
Hey, it's 7 o'clock. What's all this lounging around going on?
Welcome back, baby moon. Hey.
We missed you.
Saving this for you.
Stavros.
Cat, this is the only apron that was ever long enough for me. Stavros and I used to fight over it all the time.
That's it. You are officially back.
Well, there you go.
All right.
Come on.
All right. Hey, Cat. That was then. This is now. It's a brand new day.
if you say so, let's go.
Come on, handsome. Rise and shine.
I'm sleepy.
We have to go to the diner, remember?
Oh, right.
So, Ross, what do you think I should wear?
Shoes. It's the only dress code the diner has.
Okay, so how about I wear shoes and, this?
Hello? Holly? I don't know what...
Mother? What happens? You just sound terrible.
Survivors. And the only thing that washed up with me, like some cruel mocking Joe, was the little bag that held all my jewelry and credit cards. Which, of course, were totally useless, all of it. But that's when I realized I had just escaped death into a new life, barely a little more than the shirt on my back, and I felt strangely free. Free to be a new woman in it. A new life. Of course, I didn't realize quite how free until last night. Until I saw Roger. I'm just so sorry to have worried you all.
You know, the irony is, we found out about the shipwreck right when Roger was making his move on Spalding.
That's when you came looking for me?
Mm-hmm. We sent Fletcher and Frank Cooper to Singapore. But when there were no survivors in the crew or no sign of you, well, we had to assume the worst and we just gave up.
You know, I honestly didn't believe anyone cared enough to come looking for me.
Well, you were wrong.
Fletcher, how is he?
Oh, Fletcher. Well, Fletcher's doing fine. You know.
Good morning, Alexandra. Did you
sleep all right in the boathouse?
Oh, yes, indeed. Thank you.
Hey.
Hi.
Morning.
Good morning, honey.
Well, I better get back and do my meditation.
Meditation?
Yes, every morning. I'll explain later. First things first. I really should get started looking for a place to stay until I get my house back.
You know, why don't I call Alan Michael, have him come over for breakfast, and he can fill you in on what's going on with Spaulding.
Good. I can't wait to see him.
Well, make yourself at home.
Okay.
Well, if you're thinking about breakfast, there really isn't much in the fridge.
That's all right. I'll just go to the store.
No, let me go.
Melinda, wait a second. I have to ask you something.
Okay.
My mother came back to Springfield, and nothing is the way that she remembers it. Now, I don't think that the full impact of that has really sunk in yet.
Yeah, so what's the question?
I think my mother needs her family right now, at least until she gets her bearings. So I would like it if she could stay on next door at the boathouse for a while. That's if it's okay with you.
All right, here's what's gonna happen.
Mm-hmm.
I have to go pick up Michelle at Ness and Billy's because she has the day off from school, and I thought that maybe I should probably spend some time with her.
I have the perfect idea. We'll go to an exhibit at the museum. There's a new one there that I've been dying to see. And then I'll make a picnic lunch, and afterwards we can...
We can't. Not today. Thank you.
Oh, yeah,
I mean,
no,
it's been
I understand.
Just Michelle and me alone
yes,
for
oh,
quite
please,
some time.
Yes, oh, please, Ed, you do not have to explain
nothing...
to me. Nothing personal, I know.
Please.
Let me ask you a question. Do you regret what happened last night?
Not for a moment.
Why do things seem so different than all of a sudden...
I don't regret what happened. I'm just kind of surprised that it did. I mean, because I didn't... It wasn't what I had in mind
well,
when I came...
Well, you know... I don't know if I believe that. I think we both know what we wanted. It's just that now I feel like... Maybe when you were with Lillian, you... Obviously, you felt like you regret letting Maureen down... And now maybe with me, you feel like you're worried about Holly or something.
If I'm worried about anything, it's letting you down. I know how badly Nick hurt you, and I'm afraid of doing the same thing.
You could never let me down.
Not intentionally, no. But I don't know where this is leading. I don't know how much of there is... of me left to give, and you are so fragile right now, and I am so needy. I mean, that's what just hit me when I woke up this morning and saw you sleeping next to me. I mean, aside from this is the most beautiful woman I've ever seen in my life. I just thought I could never hurt you.
Well, you're right. Nick did hurt me. But I learned something important from it. I learned that promises aren't hard currency in this world. They're too easily broken. And I'm too scarred and battered inside to actually ever believe in them again anyway. So no matter how much I'd want to coax one out of you, I wouldn't do it. But I want you to know I'm not so greedy or so ungrateful that I regret being so completely and wonderfully happy with you right now.
Do you know that Stavros makes the most fantastic Greek omelets? Are you hungry?
Yes. I'm starved. Okay, Mom, I'll come over in a little while. Okay, bye. Something's wrong. She always gets this I don't care happy tone in her voice whenever she's upset. She sounded particularly chirpy this morning. I bet it has something to do with Eve Guthrie and Ed. What's so funny?
The role reversal is now complete. Holly's making SOS calls to you, and you're chewing on your lips, trying to manage your mother's life.
Yeah, well, I think Ed's the one who needs managing. He's acting like a fool. Not to mention putting my mother's life in danger.
Don't you think you're getting a little dramatic now?
Eve's a fruit bat, Ross. Have I told you some of the insane stunts that Mindy told my mom that she pulled on her?
Mindy? Oh, good source. Mindy Lewis has been known to exaggerate upon occasion. She's not exactly a role model herself.
Okay. Forget about my mother. Forget about Mindy. What about Ed? Aren't you concerned about him? He is your best friend.
Ed and Eve worked together at Cedars. They were colleagues and they're friends. Ed is generous with his time. There's nothing more to it than that.
So please explain Eve's Mistress of the Manor performance last night.
Blake, you are now pole vaulting to conclusions. About a lot of things.
It does look gorgeous on me, doesn't it?
Looks fabulous. Take it off. No.
I wasn't going to throw this away just because I'm mad at you.
Blake, it is not just the ring. It's what the ring is supposed to stand for.
Oh, that's not fair, Ross. How long are you going to rub my nose into that incident with Alan Michael?
I can't forget.
You know, it wouldn't have even happened in the first place if I had had this ring on my finger.
You don't know that,
oh,
Blake.
Oh, yes, I do. See, there's a big difference between you and me, Ross. You want me to act like I'm married, yet I want to be married to you. That's all wrong for somebody like me. See, I'm notoriously bad at being single. I've had enough freedom to last a lifetime. When I was a kid, I pushed hard so people would push back. I needed boundaries set for me. But my father was never there, and so my mother shoved me off to boarding school, where I really misbehaved.
Now, you're not a kid anymore, Blake. Nobody can set boundaries for you. You have to do it yourself.
And I will. But I need to feel safe. And I don't feel safe being floating around out there disconnected.
You see, you think if you put a ring on your finger, you will suddenly become a loyal and faithful wife.
And I will.
Well, good. That's good. That's very good. But I would like a little premarital preview of what that's going to be like.
So you're saying put the ring away for now?
Until the day comes when we both feel comfortable that this is going to work out.
How long do you think it will take? I mean, approximately.
Blake.
Before the end of the year, I just want to pace myself, Ross.
You know what time it is?
Early? I gotta run some errands first. But when I get back, I want to ask you some questions about Spalding before I clock in.
Spalding? You sure? Yeah, if I'm not up by the time you come back, wake me, okay?
Okay. Frankie, it was registered to Lucy Cooper.
No sign of her?
No. So Buzz filled out an official missing persons report this morning, and that's where he is, off at all the hospitals looking for her. Frankie, you know, I know you better than anybody else in the world. And I know that you do not care so little for your father as you pretend to.
I'm not pretending anything.
Frankie, why don't you just admit it, that you have feelings for Buzz, that you actually admire the man?
Oh, no, I don't admire him. I can't admire anybody I don't respect.
You know, you are so quick to grab onto the last horrible thing you hear about a man, as if that's all he is. It's just not fair, Frankie. It's not right. I mean, if that were the way to measure a person, then I would have never taken you back when I heard that you were going to commit a robbery.
Look, I did something stupid, okay?
Frankie, you would not have taken me back when I went back to Alan Michael after I promised I would leave him. I mean, we both did something stupid, but that's not who we are always. Yes, Buzz has made mistakes. But he is also the man who is responsible for giving our daughter another chance to hear. And for winning the Silver Star in the war and spending every cent he had to give Harley a beautiful wedding. So if you want to be angry, Frankie, you just go ahead and be angry. But you have to be grateful, too. Because he is all those things, the good and the bad. And if you keep ignoring those things, it does not make Buzz a lesser person, only you.
Hey, where is Bridget anyway?
Oh, she had a test to take, and she was going to try and sneak away, but she saw that her Uncle Ed was coming by, so she thought she better take that test.
A friendship ring for my best friend, love, Bridget.
Oh.
Hey.
That is nice. Look at that.
Wow.
Wow, gorgeous. Why did you give that to me?
All right, keep your hands off my
this
man.
This is from Eleni and me.
And Muddy.
And Muddy.
Hey. What's this for, Frank?
Well, that's the salary that you missed since the last day that you worked, plus 1 week's vacation pay.
Oh, right. And actually, Buzz, Nadine, and Stavros here, they pulled their tips together, and every night they would cut them in four, and so that's money's in there, too.
Yeah.
And I can't take this.
Sure you can. Sure you can. Besides, Harley and Mal, they have a gift coming for you, too. It should be here any minute, so...
No, I can't take this.
You deserve it, David.
But not, Eleni, not for work that I didn't do.
Hey, listen. If it hadn't been for you, Uncle Starvis wouldn't be standing here right now. We owe you big time, my friend. And we really want you to have this. Please take it.
Thanks, Frank. Oh,
thank you.
Thank you, everybody. Could you excuse me just for a minute, please?
Sure.
I can't take this, Kat.
What do you mean?
Look, I'm not some kind of hero. I didn't do anything to be proud of. I just want everything to be back the way that it was.
David, things are back just like they were.
No.
Yes.
No, they're not.
Yes, they are. Look, Ed, have you just forgotten how much people around here adore you?
No.
Hey, no one adores you as much as I do, so relax.
I had no idea that there was going to be a big party going on here.
Yeah, well, I think it's kind of neat.
You mean really?
Mm-hmm.
Very. I think I kind of know what David is going through. I mean, we're both celebrating our freedom and feeling kind of overwhelmed.
Hey, everybody. Hey, welcome. Hey,
welcome. Oh, Ed. Slammed the door. He drew the iron curtain. And I did tell him how I felt. I told him that I loved him, and I practically begged him for another chance. And he was very clear about how he felt. I was not going to be a part of his life now, not the way I was seeing it, so... I don't know, I drove around half the night trying to figure out how I was going to convince him that he was making a terrible mistake. And I still think he is, but so what? He doesn't, and that's what counts, right? So there it is, and I don't want to talk about it anymore.
Oh. Come on.
What?
Come here.
Where are we going?
I want you to sit right here. And I'm going to do something I wanted to do since I was a little girl.
All right.
Go to the grocery store?
No. I'm not working just for Mrs. Thorpe's television station. I do know how to dress for TV. But I'll be working at Spalding Enterprises. And I really know how to learn how to dress for Enterprises. Here. What do you think?
Too hip.
Well, how about this one?
If that skirt was any shorter, you'd get arrested.
How old did you say you were?
I didn't. You did say you wanted my help.
Okay, how about this one?
That's much better.
I figured. Look.
Where did you say you got all this stuff from?
to a place? It's called a department store.
At this hour?
Yeah, well, I heard on the radio that they were advertising this 24-hour sale.
But they weren't giving the clothes away, and you don't have any money, so...
So I had to be a little creative.
You didn't steal this stuff and bring it here, did you?
No, of course not. I just told the lady that I was Mrs. Spaulding. But when she didn't believe that, well, then I had to give your credit card imprint as a deposit.
You had no right to take my wallet.
Well, technically, no, but, you know, being a house guest and all, I just...
Lucy!
What? Okay, okay. It is your place. We'll do things your way. I'll wear the Hillary Clinton outfit, okay?
You know what? I don't care. I don't care. Wear the short skirt if you want to. Go topless to work if you want to. Wear a helmet. I don't care.
Fine. Fine. Okay, Mr. Hotshot. I'll be out of your hair as soon as possible.
I'm not trying to push you out. I'm sorry I lost my temper. Wear whatever you feel comfortable in.
Well, that's good, because I do want you to like what I'm wearing. Because after all, until I get my first paycheck, you are paying for these rags.
Listen, sweetheart, you don't have to decide right now, all right? Why don't we just put her in the Regency or the Springfield Inn until you have some time to think about it? Now, I want you to be comfortable with this, too, okay?
Ooh, something smells wonderful.
Before this goes any further, I think there's something that needs to be said.
Sounds serious.
Alexandra, ever since you left... I've hoped that I'd have a second chance. A chance to really get to know my mother. In fact, I've even dreamed about it.
I dreamed about it, too.
But I think it's important that you understand that I'm with Melinda.
Well, so you said last night.
Yes, I know, but I think it's one of those things that needs to be said again so that there's no misunderstanding about this. No, I love Melinda. And I have every intention of staying with her. Now, our progress between you and me depends on you accepting that. Why don't I call Ellen Michael again? Good, it's ringing. Ellen Michael, hey, it's Nick. Listen, I need you to come over to Melinda's right away.
Well, I'm running kind of late. Can't it wait till the office?
No, it can't wait. You have to come here right now. I have a surprise that you are not going to believe.
What is it?
You'll see. Just hurry your butt over here.
All right, I'll be there in a few minutes. Bye. Okay, where were we? Ah, yes, the most important piece of advice I can give you is, if you want to keep your job, don't let anybody know that you're staying here or that you even know me.
Right. They hate you.
No, because they know that Spaulding Enterprises is my family's by right. And any friend of mine is not going to be trusted by Jenna or by her husband.
I will never, never forget this. I mean, who's telling what might have happened if I wasn't prepared?
That's all right. It's all right. Just wanted to let you know.
Because this really is important to me. I mean, I don't have to be filthy rich like Miss Jenna Bradshaw Thorpe. Even though I do wonder what it must be like to go shopping and buy anything you want and never think about what it costs.
Yeah, well, there are certain freedoms that come with having that kind of money.
Well, you're not exactly a quadrillionaire anymore, but you're not exactly tapped out either. I mean, you've got a newspaper, you've got this houseboat. Talk about freedom. You could just push off and float anywhere you want it. What?
You're right. It's the outfit. It's just not you. How much did you say that other outfit that you liked was?
More than this one.
Here. Go get it.
You mean this?
Yeah, as a matter of fact, get the scarf with it, too.
You're kidding. No, thank you.
No, it's okay.
Thank you.
It's all right, just don't do that anymore, okay? I gotta go. I'll check you later, see how your first day went. Look, I know I'm really beginning to sound like a broken record, but you really shouldn't have.
No. Hey, yeah, well, you're right. Obviously terribly bored.
Oh,
now open
goodness.
That one.
Right. That one is for me, David. Oh, it's not as creative as some of the others, but it goes with a tuxedo. But you'll have to pick it out. I got so thin, I didn't know the size.
A tuxedo for me?
Mm-hmm. I just thought every gentleman should have formal wear.
A tuxedo is perfect. I love it.
There are a lot of affairs you will be invited to. I wouldn't be a bit surprised if Senator Collier invited you to a dinner, although she did snub a dinner invitation at my house, and she was only a judge.
Well, I tell you what, I'll put in a good word for you with the senator, Mom.
I'll put in a good word for you.
Excuse me.
How long do you think it will take before he gets the hint?
Oh, Frankie, isn't it against the law to refuse to serve a customer?
Well, he's going to have to sue me then because he's not getting a drop of water in his place. Excuse me.
Don't worry, Elaine. I'll take care of it.
Oh, thank you. I guess Hamp decided not to come?
No, I just decided not to invite him.
Okay. Look, I know you're angry with him, but David is very grateful. I mean, after all, Hamp really came through for him on the hearing.
I guess David's just a little bit more willing to forgive and forget than I am.
So what can I get you?
I know I'm not very welcome here.
Cup of coffee?
Yeah, sure. Thanks. Yeah, I just want you to know that I think things turned out the way they should have.
Is that a fact?
Look, I hope you understand that I was just taking care of my own, just like you.
You wanted to kill me, man. I don't see how that can fall under the category of protecting your own.
That was my grief talking back then. That's not me, David.
I would have been just as dead either way.
I wouldn't have hurt you. But I guess you heard I'm supposed to go before the grand jury next week.
Yeah, I heard about that.
You're probably going to be called to testify. I just hope that you can give me the benefit of the doubt. If you can, that's all. I'm trying to support my mother and my sister, and I'm helping put Rocky's youngest kid through college. I just don't know what's going to happen to my family if I get
sick. Did you ever think about David? Did you ever think about his family and all the people who loved and supported and cared about him? Did you ever think about that?
Yeah.
I hope that I get called to testify, because if I do, I'm going to get up there and say whatever it is I need to say to make sure that you are so old and locked up that you won't ever be able to hurt anyone else again the way that you did David. Sorry, David, but I don't need to be polite to the people that are mean to you. And it may be a lot easier for you to forgive them, but I had to look at those people a lot more than you had to. And I'm not going to ever, ever forget what they did to you. Ever.
Congratulations, Counselor. You did a wonderful job for David.
Thank you very much, Ed. I was just about to stop over and say hello.
Were you? That's right. Eve said that you and Blake stopped over to say hello last night at the house.
Yes, but it wasn't important. I mean, you know Blake. She won't call it a night if even one of her friends is still up. Part of being young, I guess.
Blake is young, isn't she? She's even younger than Eve. So why don't we both stop beating around the bush?
Edward, I don't know what you're talking about.
Yeah.
Hey, sweetie.
Hi, guys.
I was just about to come pick you up. Listen, would you mind just hanging out here for a second? I want to talk to Mr. Marler outside in the alley just for a bit, okay?
Sure.
All right.
Okay. Shoot.
It's not as if I'm surprised to see you and Eve Guthrie together.
Uh-huh.
All right, I'm a little shocked. You know, Blake said that she thought something might be going on between the two of you, and I told her it was all in her imagination. Apparently, I was very wrong.
You were very wrong, and you don't really approve, do you?
No, I didn't say that.
Well, say something, buddy.
It's just that I don't know Eve Guthrie very well, whereas you and I, we go back a lot of years. This is kind of awkward for me, but as your friend, I think I should tell you that I have heard a few things about her.
Like what?
Well, let's just say that Eve Guthrie sounds like a handful.
Sort of the same thing people say about Blake, isn't it?
Good point, Ed.
Do you remember back when you came into my office and told me you were going out with Blake, how embarrassed you felt, how unsure of where it was all going?
Mm.
And I thought, he is making such a fool of himself, and that's probably what you think of me now.
Ed, I don't think...
Of course I'm a fool. But I'm a happy fool. Instead of some pitiful, miserable widower walking around with a dark cloud over my head, she makes me so happy, Rose.
I think fools like us should stick together. What was surprising in seeing you with Eve is that if I thought you were going to be with anybody after Marine, it was going to be Hobby.
I had to let go, probably for the same reasons you did.
Roger. The sad part of that is she'll never be happy with me.
No. Holly will never be happy without him.
So what do you think?
I don't know, honey. It's not really me, is it?
Well, that's the idea. It's supposed to be new, different, liberating.
Ed's not going to fall for a disguise. It's still the same old me underneath.
Mom, Ed is just lonely. He's feeling his oats right now. Oh. Eve Guthrie would be so easy to get out of the way if you just put your mind to it. Besides, Ed's only problem with you is that one bedtime slip with Dad. And I'm living proof that that doesn't have to be fatal.
You're forgetting one important thing. Ross loves you.
But Ed loves you.
No, he doesn't. He cares for me. He has feelings for me. But bottom line, he's a very practical man, and he has decided that those feelings don't mean love.
But, Mom, if you just...
No, honey. I know you're just trying to help, and I love you for it. I really do. But I'm just going to have to get those things I thought I was going to get from Ed, from myself. And in the cold light of day, that just may be liberating enough. It's gonna have to be.
Nick, do you want to know why I really left? Why it took so long to come back?
I was ashamed. Ashamed of the way I acted last year. Ashamed of the way I treated you. See, I thought I'd lost any hope to a relationship with the person most precious to me in the world, my son. My teacher said that anger is like a fiery ball a man picks up to hurl towards another, but can't because it burns his own hand. And that's what I did to you, Mindy. And I promise you that will never happen again. I may not have learned complete tolerance, serenity, but I do have more inner peace. That wasn't until I saw Roger. I don't even think the Buddhists have a saying that can help me with him.
Welcome home.
And this is your home.
I beg your pardon.
Nick and I were talking earlier, and we realized that it's silly for you to go and look for another place to live. Why don't you just stay on here at the boathouse?
Oh, that's very sweet, but I couldn't put you out.
No, you're not.
I can go down to the boathouse, get the rest of my stuff, and you can just have a lot of room down there.
Mindy, you don't have to do this.
We want to.
So it's settled. Thank you. It's probably Alamar.
Hey!
Oh, hi.
Can somebody accept a package for Nick McHenry next door?
Well, that's me, so I should be able to accept it, right?
What is it?
Hey, it's that journalism award I won last January.
An award?
Yeah.
What's it for?
Well, it was for a series of articles I wrote on Cambrai.
Cambrai? Speaking of which, how is Yves Guthrie?
There's a $16 shipping charge.
Oh, yeah, of course. Let me see. Damn it. I spent all my money at the store.
Mm. Hey! So, come on. What is it you want me to see?
Be really desperate for new recruits.
Well, you know what they say, a few good men and women.
Hey, look, I'm just curious, but would a juvenile record keep one out of the police academy?
Well, why don't you stop by the office and we'll talk about it. Have your attention, please.
Excuse me, but what are you thinking about?
I got a little announcement to make. Actually, it's a big announcement. Our favorite honeymooners, Harley and Mallet, have bestowed upon David the ultimate gift to go along with his paid vacation.
Uh-oh.
Mallet's World Series tickets.
This is from me.
Let's see this star, bro.
Hurry.
That's beautiful.
Yes, it's not for taking orders. I want you to use this to write love poems to this guy. Welcome home, my friend.
I hear a piano strain, a clear again. So let's sing a song of cheer again. Happy days I hear again. All together, shouting now there's no one who can stop it now. So let's tell the world about it now.
How much is that again?
$16.
Listen, I hate to break up this tender moment, but does anybody have any money? I gotta pay this guy.
What
do you have, Michael? Do you have anything?
No, nothing. Nothing at all.
I have to have foreign money.
Let me see. Oh, great.
I got
you take
it.
The
I got it.
Oh, great. Thank you, honey.
Hey, Alex. I'm sorry. It's all gone. Everything that you left, I lost it all.
No, darling. Aunt Alex is back, and the rest will follow.
This has been Guiding Light. Jewelry by Monet. Thank you.
It's time for the Black Knight to make his next move. Checkmate, Jack. Tomorrow on The Young and the Restless.